Hello, and welcome to the Daily Almanac for
October 2nd.
So, let's get started.
This day in history!
On this day in history, October 2nd, 1721, the first record of a camel being in America was mentioned in the Boston Gazette. In 1856, a number of camels were brought into the U.S. to be used for military purposes. Also, on this date in 1950, the comic strip Peanuts by Charles M. Schulz was first published. The comic strip, featuring characters such as Charlie Brown, Lucy, a dog named Snoopy, and a bird named Woodstock, became one of the most popular comic strips in history, reaching people in 75 countries. And on this day in 1967, Thurgood Marshall was sworn in as a Supreme Court Justice. Long before President Lyndon Johnson appointed him the first African-American Supreme Court Justice, Marshall had established himself as the nation's leading civil rights lawyer. In 1954, he was recognized for his successful argument of the Brown versus Board of Education of Topeka case. In that case, the Supreme Court ruled that public school segregation was an unconstitutional violation of rights guaranteed by the 14th Amendment.
Word power!
Today on Word Power, I want to talk about something spooky. Halloween. Do you know where the word Halloween comes from? Well, for thousands of years, Christians in Europe have celebrated their religious saints on the first day of November. They call this special holiday All Saints' Day or All Hallows' Day. They call the night before All Hallows' Day All Hallow-Even. They believe that on All Hallow-Even, the human and spirit world could come together. So look out for ghostly visitors when you're out trick or treating. Today on Extremes, we ask, what is the smallest mammal in the world? The answer is a bat from Thailand. It's called Kitley's hog-nosed bat, and it's only about 1.14 inches, and that's just 2.9 centimeters long, and it weighs only about 0.06 of an ounce, which is just 1.7 grams. This bat is smaller than many insects and snails.
Health tips.
One day, you might be in a situation where you're being pressured by a friend or somebody you know to do something you don't want to do. Well, if that happens, here are four steps that can help you out. Step one, say no and say it clearly, no. Step two, give a reason. Explain why you don't want to do it. For example, it's dangerous or I'm not allowed. Step three, suggest something else that you can do instead. For example, let's take a bike ride or go to a friend's house. And finally, if none of the first three steps work, go to step four, leave, walk away. If you think something is unsafe or wrong, trust yourself. Don't do it, even if other kids dare you to try. Except for Native Americans, the United States is a nation of people who left their home country looking for a better life. For this reason, the United States is sometimes called the melting pot. As a result, the population of the United States is made up of a mixture of people from different countries, such as Ireland and China and Mexico. Now, can a person who is not born in the United States become a citizen? Well, yes. A person who is born elsewhere is living legally in the United States and has passed a test on the Constitution and the history of the United States can become a naturalized citizen. Well, that's all the time we have left today for Daily Almanac. Thanks for stopping by, and I hope to see you tomorrow.